Welcome to the tutorial on the C programming language. This is our 12th lecture in which we will discuss about the installation of the C compiler. As of now, we know that C is a high-level programming language, and this language cannot directly understood by a computer. So we need to convert this language into a machine-readable form, and that will be done by a compiler. So how to write a program, how to compile this program, and how we can see the output, that we will discuss during this lecture. So outline of our lecture: how you can install a GCC, the C compiler, in Ubuntu 18.04 version. Next, we will see how you can write a simple program, then how to compile and execute the program, and at the end we will see the process of compilation and running a C program. So starting with the installation of the C compiler. So what is our objective? To install a GCC, the C compiler, in Ubuntu 18.4. So the what operating system we are using? We are installing a GCC in 18.04 Ubuntu operating system. So what are the requirement? You should have access to your Ubuntu operating system as a root or via sudo command is required. Next, within a hash, that is with the root privileges, either directly as a root user, or you can use a sudo command. And dollar sign require a given Unix Linux command to be executed as a regular non-privileged user. Next, how you can install a GCC? Open your Ubuntu operating system, and within that open the terminal. Within a terminal you need to write this command sudo, that is for a super user, space apt space install GCC, and then press enter. It requires some time to install a GCC within your system. Another way to install a GCC in your Ubuntu operating system, using a build essential, it will install an additional library as well as G++ compiler, that is used for a C++ programming language, that is the object oriented programming language. So using this command you can install a GCC plus G++ compiler, or as well as some additional libraries. So open the terminal and type a sudo space apt space install build essential. This is the another way to install a GCC. So after installation, check whether the compiler are properly installed or not. What you have to write: GCC space hyphen version. It will give you a version of the GCC that will be installed to your compiler. So these are the sequence of the steps that you have to follow to install a compiler to your Ubuntu operating system. Now we have a compiler that will convert our program. So you need to write a program. So where you will write the program? So they are the system software provided by Ubuntu, that is known as the gEditor, in which you can write your program in a C language. So how you can write a program? Let's see. So for that you have to open the gEditor. How you will open the gEditor? Go to a terminal and type a gedit. It will open a gEditor window, that is nothing but like a notepad where you can write your program. So within this window, write this program. Just type the program, don't worry about the all the thing that is given within a program. We will discuss each and everything in detail in our next lecture. After writing this program, save your file with .c extension. Suppose this is our first lecture, first program, so we will save our file with the hello.c extension, c name. You can write this program like that, as well as you can write a program directly writing this command gedit space hello.c. What will this command do? It will open a gEditor with the file hello.c. Within that you write this program and save your file. So we have a compiler and we has also write a program in a high level programming language, but this code will not understood by a machine. So we need to compile this code, so compiler will convert into a machine readable form. So next we will see how to compile and execute a program. So for a compilation, again open a terminal and type gcc space hello.c. This statement compile your program and create a executable file that is a.out. And to see the program output, you have to open this file using .a.out. It will give you a output within a terminal. So instead of these two command, you can also create an object file like this, gcc hyphen o. O is stand for a object, hello space hello dot c. It will create a hello dot o object file, and you can open this file by writing .hello. So it will give you an output within a terminal that will be a hello word that is printed in a previous example. So we will see the process of compiling and running a C program. So how you can execute a C program? First step, you have to create a program by using a gEditor. Write your program and save your program with .c extension. Next step, we have to compile this program using a gcc compiler like a gcc space hello.c. Next step is linking the program with the function that are needed from the C library that we will discuss, and at the end execute the program using a .a.out. Now what is the linking? Linking is the process of putting together other program files and functions that are required in a program. Suppose we are using, in a previous example, we have used the printf functions, that is nothing but the output function. Whatever you are writing within a printf functions is displayed as an output. But this printf function is built-in function that is defined within a library stdio.h. So we need to combine this, we need to link this printf function with this library, that is known as the linking. Let's take another example. Suppose you are using exponential functions of the math library, so you have to include this math library and you have to link this function with this library, that is known as the linking. Executable object code. The compiled and linked program is called executable object code and is stored automatically in another file name called a.out, that is your executable file. So this is the all over process of compiling and running a C program. Start with the system, enter a program. If you want to edit your code, then your code is ready for a execution. Then compile your code, that is known as your source code. If is there any syntax error, if is there any grammatical or spell mistake, then remove this error. If yes, then again edit your source code, again compile a code. If there is not any syntax error, then linker will link all the system libraries with the particular functions and you will get the executable object code. Then see for a logic and data error. This is nothing but the error, runtime error. Suppose you want to write a program to add a two numbers. So instead of C is equal to A plus B, if you are writing C is equal to A minus B, so compiler will subtract a two number instead of adding a two number. So you can remove this error if you want, then edit a source code, again compile a code, then again linking, and you will get the executable code, and then according to that you will get the correct output and stop the program. So within this lecture we had discussed how to install a compiler, C compiler, within a Ubuntu operating system, how you can write a simple program, and how to execute or compile the program, and how to see the output. Thank you.